Carl Sagan once said, "The universe is a pretty big place. If it's just us, it seems like an awful waste of space." Our universe is massive, if not infinite. There is plenty of room for aliens out there. Many of us have looked at the night sky and wondered who else is out there at one point or another. So, what are the odds that there are other intelligent beings out there? It won't be a scientific fact, but we can use this. Hello, and thanks for watching Paralopedia, your source for what is, isn't, and might be true about paranormal phenomenon. I'm Jason from parafiles.net, and today we're looking at the Drake Equation. The Drake Equation is a formula to estimate the number of planets in the Milky Way that could harbor intelligent enough beings to possibly contact us at this moment in time. In 1960, at the National Radio Astronomy Observatory in Green Banks, West Virginia, Frank Drake conducted the first search for radio signals from extraterrestrial civilizations. Soon afterwards, the National Academy of Sciences asked Drake to assemble a meeting on detecting extraterrestrial intelligence using radio. At this meeting, Drake showed off his equation for the first time. This meeting would go on to lay the groundwork for SETI, or the search for extraterrestrial intelligence. Here's what the Drake equation looks like. Most of the parts of this equation can only be filled out by making educated guesses and assumptions, but the Drake equation is more of a thought experiment than anything else. So just keep that in mind. N is what we're trying to solve for with this equation. It's the number of broadcasting civilizations, meaning civilizations like ours that are broadcasting signals from our own Milky Way galaxy into space and might be able to communicate with us at this moment in time. R is the average rate of formation of suitable stars in the Milky Way galaxy. FP is the fraction of stars that form planets. NE is the average number of habitable planets per star. FL is a fraction of habitable planets where life emerges. FI is a fraction of habitable planets with life where intelligence evolves. FC is a fraction of planets with intelligent life capable of interstellar communication. L is the number of years a civilization remains detectable. The first number we need to come up with is R, yearly star formation in the Milky Way. This is one of the only numbers in this equation we know, and that number is 7 according to NASA's best estimates. Next is the fraction of stars that form planets. Our star has 8 planets, and as of February 2018, we have discovered 3,728 exoplanets, or planets in other solar systems. Let's come up with a conservative estimate here. Since the number really is unknowable, let's just say every star has 1 planet. So FP equals 1. The next number we need to plug in is NE, the average number of habitable planets per star. On November 4th, 2013, astronomers reported that based on Kepler's space mission data, that there could be as many as 40 billion Earth-sized planets orbiting in the habitable zones of sun-like stars within the Milky Way galaxy. So now we need to see how many stars are in our galaxy, so we know what percentage of stars have Earth-like planets in the Milky Way. According to astronomers' best estimates, there are 250 billion, plus or minus 150 billion. So 100 billion here is a conservative number. That means we could plug in 0.4 into NE. The next part is FL, the fraction of habitable planets where life emerges. This part is hard to answer. There has been some sketchy evidence that life was once on Mars, such as the Martian meteorite that was found in Antarctica, ALH84001, that some think shows ancient fossilized bacterial life, or NASA's Viking lander mission in 1976, where one of the landers detected methane, but was later ruled a false positive. If life had ever evolved on Mars, and here on Earth, then chances are life would be very abundant in the universe. Now this is just Earth and Mars. There's a lot of speculation that moons like Europa could also harbor life. Since we can't know this number for sure, let's say that half of planets that could support life will at some point. So FL will be 0.5. The next part is FI. This is a fraction of habitable planets with life where intelligence evolves. We live on a planet that has seen billions of species die off, and really only one, that being us, evolve enough to even think about other life forms being out in the universe. That makes many question how common intelligence is, if it's just happened once out of billions of species, but I honestly think if we hadn't evolved to where we are now, it might take several more million years, but something would have been there to take our place. Since all life forms seem to become more complex as they evolve, I think intelligent life is almost inevitable, as long as they have a place to evolve. Again, since this can't be known, let's just say it happens half the time. The next two parts are FC, fraction of plants with intelligent life capable of interstellar communication, and L, years that civilization remains detectable. Somewhat go hand in hand, so we'll look at these at the same time. Modern humans, like you and me, only evolved around 200,000 years ago. Civilization, as we know, has only been around for 6,000 years, and industrialization started in the 1800s. We've only been broadcasting radio for around 100 years. Now, depending on who you ask, they might tell you we'll all be dead within the next decade. But obviously no one knows this answer. We'll be conservative and say FC will be 0.1, and L will be 500. Using these numbers, in Drake's equation, we come up with the answer of 35. Since there is so much speculation involved with plugging numbers into this formula, almost everyone will come up with a different number. There's definitely one intelligent civilization in the Milky Way, and that's us. But there could be thousands. Using this formula to figure out how many civilizations are out there is about as useful as asking someone how much a house cost, and having them tell you somewhere between $1 and $50 billion. Many people have done the Drake equation before and met with the same brick wall we just did, but that's not why I wanted to do this video. I'm not sure if any of you noticed what I did about this equation. I didn't think about it the first few times I read about it, but N really is a variable itself. Remember, N is the number of civilizations at our technical level or higher in the Milky Way. The Milky Way is just one galaxy. So how many galaxies are out there? Astronomers' best estimate is there are between 100 and 200 billion galaxies out there. Just by the sheer number of galaxies, if we just got a fraction of a number, like 10 to the negative 11 power, or 0.000000001 from the Drake equation, and multiply that by 100 billion, the smallest estimate of galaxies there is, we still come up with one other civilization out there right now, just like us, looking up to the sky and wondering who else is out there. This wasn't meant to prove anything, which it hasn't. But with as big as the universe is, I think it's far more likely that there are many civilizations out there than I think we are the only ones. Thanks for watching. You should totally check out parafiles.net for more on this and anything else paranormal related. Also, be sure to check out the Smoke and Mirrors podcast. Episode 6 about alien disclosure is definitely worth checking out. Take care and remember, there's no reason to be normal when you can be paranormal.